हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर श्रीनिवास केशंटी. वेलकम टू द लास्ट सेशन ऑन दिस फर्स्ट यूनिट, क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर. इन दिस सेशन लेट अस स्टडी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डायमंड एंड NaCl. इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड सम सिंपल क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर्स लाइक हेक्सागोनल क्लोज पैक्ड स्ट्रक्चर, फेस सेंटर्ड क्यूबिक क्लोज पैक्ड स्ट्रक्चर, then simple cubic and body centered cubic. So let us study two structures, diamond and NaCl structure. Diamond exhibits a cubical and hexagonal type structure. It exhibits cubical and hexagonal type structure. The diamond cubic structure is more common, which is we are going to describe here, the diamond cubic structure. The space lattice of diamond cubic structure is FCC. The space lattice of diamond cubic structure is face-centered cubic with basis consisting of two carbon atoms, isn't it? So lattice is face-centered cubic and basis is consisting of two carbon atoms, one located at the lattice point, and another located at the at a distance of one quarter of the body diagonal, isn't it? So one carbon atom is located at the lattice point. For example, here it is located at the corner and another is located at the one quarter of the diagonal. This black atom, isn't it? I am going to show you with the help of the pointer, isn't it? So space lattice of DC structure is FCC, face centered cubic, with basis consisting of two carbon atoms, one located at the lattice point and another located at a distance of one quarter of the body diagonal, isn't it? So it another atom of the basis is located at 1/4 distance from that atom along the body diagonal. Okay. The unit cell of DC structure is shown in figure. The carbon atoms placed along the body diagonals occupy a tetrahedral void positions in the FCC arrangement, isn't it? So the diamond cubic structure is shown in the first figure, isn't it? So, and the carbon atoms placed along the body diagonals, the atoms shown by the black color, these atoms which are located along the body diagonals are located at the tetrahedral void positions in the FCC arrangement. So this opens up a close packed structure. Actually FCC is a close packed structure that we have studied, but due to these carbon atoms which are located along the body diagonals, isn't it, this FCC structure opens up. This also decreases the packing efficiency. Packing efficiency of a FCC structure is 74%, isn't it? It is 74%. But due to the occupancy of these carbon atoms along the body diagonals, the FCC structure opens up. It no longer remains a close packed structure. It becomes a loose packed structure and its packing efficiency comes down to 34%. The coordination number of each atom is 4, isn't it? So the coordination of each atom is 4. So this black carbon atom is connected to 4 nearby carbon atoms. So the coordination number of each carbon atom is 4 and the nearest neighboring distance is under root 3/4. The number of carbon atoms per unit cell is 8, isn't it? So coordination number of each carbon atom is 4 and the number of carbon atoms per unit cell is 8. So how it is 8, we will try to find it out. There are 8 carbon atoms at the corners, 6 carbon atoms at the face centered position. So the contribution of 8 carbon atoms at the corners is 1 by 8 into 8 is 1. The contribution of 6 carbon atoms at the face centered position is there are 6 atoms at the face centered position is 6 into 1 by 2 is 3. So previous one 1 plus 3, isn't it? It is equal to 4, and there are 4 carbon atoms inside, isn't it? So that 4 plus this 4 comes out to be 8. So the number of atoms per unit cell is 8, and the coordination number of each carbon atom is 4. The DC structure may be viewed as an interpenetration. So here there is a spelling mistake, interpretation is there. It is an interpenetration of two FCC sublattices with origins 0, 0, 0 and 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4. So it can be viewed as as interpenetration of two FCC sublattices with origins 0, 0, 0 and 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4. A plan view of all carbon atoms in a unit cell is shown in the second figure. The fractional heights of carbon atoms relative to base of unit cell are given in the circles at the atomic positions, isn't it? So this is a plan view. This is a plan view. So here 0 and 1 represents the relative distances of the carbon atoms. So the same circle represents two numbers. 0 means which 0, this 0 means this carbon atom, and this 1 means this carbon atom. So they are one over other. 0 means this carbon atom and 1 means this carbon atom. This 1 by 2 means this face centered, the carbon atom located at the face centered. 1 by 4 means this carbon atom, black carbon atom located along the body diagonal, isn't it? So this 1 by 2 means this carbon atom located at the face center, isn't it? So in this way you can visualize this plan view, you can understand this plan view, isn't it? So a plan view of all the carbon atoms in a unit cell is shown in figure. The fractional heights of carbon atoms relative to the fractional height of carbon atoms relative to base of the unit cell are given in the circles at the atomic positions. The number in the same circle indicate carbon atoms at the same positions, one above the other, that I have explained. In diamond, the carbon atoms are bound to each other by directional covalent bond. Covalent bond is a directional bond. In covalent bond, there is a exchange of electrons from one, there is a sharing of equal number of electrons between the two atoms. So this is a directional kind of bond. Each carbon atom forms covalent bond with four other carbon atoms that occupy four corners of the cube in a tetrahedral structure, isn't it? So this black atom, you can visualize, it is bound to four nearby carbon atoms, this 1, 2, 3 and this 4, isn't it? Okay, so it forms a tetrahedral structure. It forms a tetrahedral structure. Each carbon atom forms a covalent bond with four other carbon atoms that occupy four corners of a cube in the tetrahedral structure. The length of the bond is 0.154 nanometer and bonding angle is 109.5 degrees, isn't it? So we are going to study the covalent bond and carbon diamond structure diamond structure in the next unit, isn't it? The entire diamond structure is made up of such tetrahedral units. So entire diamond structure is made up of such tetrahedral units. Apart from carbon, diamond, silicon, germanium, silicon carbon, gallium arsenide, great tin also show the same kind of structure. So this is about the diamond structure. Now we will study the last is NaCl structure, isn't it? So the unit cell of NaCl is shown in figure. In NaCl, the radii of Na plus and Cl minus are such that each Na plus ion is octahedrally coordinated with six chlorine ions, isn't it? So each Na plus ion is octahedrally coordinated. Suppose this is Na plus ion, so it is octahedrally coordinated with six chlorine ions. Which are the six chlorine ions? This one chlorine ion, another chlorine ion, this chlorine ion, this chlorine ion, this chlorine ion, and this chlorine ion. So each Na plus ion is octahedrally coordinated to six chlorine ions. The unit cell is FCC. Unit cell is again face-centered cubic with four chlorine ions occupying four FCC positions. So four chlorine ions are occupying four FCC positions and all four Na plus ions occupying all octahedral void positions. The FCC positions and the octahedral void positions are, however, interchangeable. So these positions, isn't it? FCC positions, face-centered cubic positions, isn't it? Face-centered cubic positions and octahedral void positions shown by these green atoms. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Isn't it? So these positions are interchangeable. They can be occupied by either sodium atoms or chlorine. If chlorine atoms are occupying FCC positions, then sodium atoms are occupying octahedral void positions and vice versa, isn't it? The NaCl structure can therefore be viewed as two interpenetrating FCC sublattices like the previous carbon diamond structure, one belonging to Na plus ions with its origin at point 000 and other belonging to Cl minus ions with its origin at point A by 200, isn't it? So like one at 000, if you consider the Na plus to be at 000 and other we can consider this to be origin with origin at A by 200, isn't it? The structure is FCC sublattice with basis consisting of two ions, one Na plus and other chlorine minus. One occupies FCC position and other occupies octahedral void position. A unit cell of NaCl comprising four molecules. Isn't it? A unit cell of NaCl comprises four molecules. So four NaCl molecules make such type of structure, isn't it? So how four molecules come here, isn't it? The positions of various ions in unit cell are shown in the figure. So we were describing the four NaCl molecules, isn't it? So if we consider this to be Na, this the corner atoms to be Na atoms, isn't it? So there are eight corners. Contribution of these carbon atoms to that particular cell is how much? 1/8, isn't it? And again, if we consider this blue as carbon atoms, then there are अगेन सिक्स कार्बन एटम्स लोकेटेड एट द सिक्स फेस सेंटर्ड पोजिशन, फेस सेंटर पोजिशन. सो वट इज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ दिस सिक्स एटम्स एट द फेस सेंटर पोजिशन विच इज इक्वल टू थ्री. सिक्स इंटू वन बाय टू विच इज इक्वल टू थ्री, इज इट इट. थ्री प्लस the corner atoms, contribution of the atoms at the corner 1, so that is 4 Na. similarly octahedral void positions, if we have considered this to be Na, then these are chlorine atoms. So how many chlorine atoms are there at the octahedral void positions, isn't it? So this 1 2 3 4, similarly 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12, isn't it? So 12 atoms are located at the octahedral void positions, isn't it? They are shared by, each atom is shared by 4 units, isn't it? So 12 divided by 4 comes out to be equal to 3. 3 plus the atom at the center, the atom at the center, that is 1, so that comes out to be 4. So 4 NaCl molecules make it such type of structure, isn't it? So Na plus ions, we are discussing the positions of various ions in unit cell are Na plus. This is, suppose this green, this is origin, this is origin, this is origin, okay. So it is said to be 0. So this green atom, let us consider to be sodium. Another green atom is here, which is in the xy plane. Suppose this is x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis. So this is xy plane. So we can consider to be 1/2, 1/2, 0. 1/2, 1/2, 0. This is in the yz plane, xz plane. This is in the xz plane. So it is 1/2, 0, 1/2. And this atom is in the zy plane. This is in the zy plane. So 0, 1/2, 1/2. Okay. Similarly, chlorine atoms. This chlorine atom, which is at a distance of 1/2, 1/2. Other is 0, 0, 1/2. So this can be considered as this for this atom, the coordinate, this is on the x axis, so 1/2, 0, 0. The atom on the y axis 0, 1/2, 0. Atom on the z axis 0, 0, 1/2. So 0, 0, 1/2, 0, 1/2, 0, 1/2, 0, 0. So in this way, the positions of various ions in the unit cell can be shown. The coordination number of each NaCl for opposite kind of ions is 6, and nearest neighboring distance is 1/2. The coordination number of NaCl for opposite kind of ions, that we have shown, isn't it? So if this green is Na, the coordination number is 6. So for opposite kind of ions, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This blue atoms, this 6, isn't it? So the coordination number of NaCl for opposite kind of ions is 6, and nearest neighboring distance is a/2. Nearest neighboring distance is a/2. If we consider this distance of the cube to be equal to a, so the nearest neighboring distance is equal to a/2, isn't it? The coordination number for same kind of atoms is 12. The coordination number for same kind of atoms. So for this green atom, the coordination number of same kind of atoms is 12. You can see there are 12 green atoms nearer this atom, isn't it? So this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, isn't it? 9, 10, 11, 12, is it? The coordination number for same kind of ions is 12, and nearest neighboring distance is a under root 2. So this distance, nearest neighboring distance is a under root 2. So here also the structure is shown. So the NaCl structure looks like this. If this is Na, then this blue comes out to be Cl. They are interchangeable. This is the same structure is shown in some other format in a colored diagram, isn't it? So it is a FCC's type of structure, isn't it? So we come to the end of the chapter and session. In this chapter we have studied what is the what is crystallography, why we study crystallography. Then we have studied what is meant by space lattice and translation vectors. Then we have studied what is meant by unit cell, then what is meant by basis, then what is how a crystal lattice is formed, crystal lattice is formed. So space lattice plus basis is equal to crystal structure. Then we have studied point groups and space groups. Then we have studied some symmetry operations, that are translation, rotation, reflection and inversion. Then we have studied some two simple types of lattices, two dimensional lattices and three dimensional lattices. So in two dimensional lattices there are four crystal systems and five previous lattices. In three dimensional lattices we have studied seven crystal systems and 14 previous lattices. Then we have studied simple crystal structures, close packed structure and loose packed structure. In close packed structure we have studied hexagonal close packed structure and face centered cubic close packed structure. In loose packed structure we have studied body centered cubic and simple cubic structure. Then we have studied two special examples of the crystal structure, that is NaCl structure and diamond structure. So we come to the end of the unit. Thank you very much. Watch our channel, like, share and comment on our videos, and don't forget to press the bell button, bell icon. Take care. Thank you very much.